Here's our list of Taiwan's top 5 LGBTQ+ issues you should know about in no particular order. You can find the full episodes and features in the description below. And if there are any other issues you'd like to see us explore in our next season, let us know in the comments.
I think the situation is getting better, but still not enough. So many LGBT are still in the closets. There's still discrimination happened, and we don't have a comprehensive equality law or anti-discrimination law. And for transgender people, they are still suffer from these binary settings.
So this white paper was done by like 4 LGBT and gender organizations. So many people think that like Taiwan has legalized same-sex marriage since 2019. So many people think that you already achieved like equality for LGBT, but that's not the truth. Actually, so we found out that there are many issues still need to be dealt with within the Taiwan LGBT community. So in this white paper, actually it includes like 5 aspects of LGBT lives, like education, workplace, intimacy relationship and family, health and social welfare, and society and politics engagement. So it includes about many issues, like some issues that still need to be done for marriage equality, like the right to use reproductive technology, and like equality law, and the implementation of gender equity education, and the long-term care, and also like the rights for transgender people. So we hope that like the presidential candidates, the political party, and also the legislative candidate, they can use this white paper. They can take a look and to use this to make their like policies more LGBT inclusive.
While Taiwan is one of the most progressive countries in Asia for LGBTQ rights, many still consider it a conservative society. This can make it especially challenging for the LGBTQ community to gain acceptance from their parents. A struggle which hotline worker Wei Junchen can relate to.
大三的时候在热线实习，那时候正在做的婚姻平权的运动的电访调查，所以我就觉得啊。 好，那我尝试着拨电话回家，我就想要知道他们对自己同志小孩子的看法。然后一打电话回家呢，发现哎，是爸爸接。那时候我愣了5秒钟，对。然后我那时候就是很紧张，我不知道怎么做，对。然后我想到哎，我现在来工作是要问问题，所以我就开始问了问题。那我把问题就是哎，你接不接受同志婚姻啊？你有没有同志朋友啊？之类这些问题啊，就问完。我爸都说啊，他没有同志朋友，他不接受同志婚姻这样子。 我挂掉电话后，我其实心里很复杂。第一个原因是因为我爸没有认出我声音，第二个是，就是我爸当着我的面不接受同志，等于说否定我这样子。It's
an issue that Georgia Guo is familiar with. 20 years ago, she attended her first counseling session with Hotline to help understand and come to terms with her child's sexuality.
我走进去之后，我是第5位啊妈妈啊。 然后有另外的4个爸妈都在哭，那我当时就觉得说，我的震撼是说，哦，原来一个同志的爸爸妈妈是如此的辛苦，是如此的困难去接受这样一个事实。当然是因为资讯的缺乏，还有不了解自己小孩子的过程嘛，所以那时候就有发愿说，哦，好像我们可以帮一点忙。
Georgia is a mother of a transgender person and has become a regular at Pride events. She even started her own association, Loving Parents of LGBT, to bridge the gap between LGBTQ children and their parents.
其实这些爸妈所感觉到的孤单，就跟同志自己发现自己身份时候的孤单，其实是一样的。因为我觉得我了解越多，我越能够去有立场去帮忙他，怎么样跟他的爸妈接触，帮忙他的爸爸妈妈去了解他。
An understanding that Wei Jun's parents have now formed after years of conversations.
我有邀请我爸爸去参加我们就是热线的父母的活动，然后去协助其他父母这样子。 然后我爸就在现场就说啊，他很快就接受了。然后我妈就跟他说，你六年你才接受。我爸说哦，这么久、哦，就是对他来说，这六年是一瞬间，但是其实是很长的一段时间。
我觉得台湾的跨性别目前生活其实都算蛮低调的耶，就是像我们很常看到欧美国家或是泰国的朋友，其实他们跨性别都还蛮高调的，就是然后穿得很就是很花，就是非常敢展现自己。对，但是在台湾跨性别朋友反而是我不希望人家希望我不希望人家知道我是跨性别，越少人知道越好。对，反而是觉得说我希望我再像女生一点，这样就不会被人家认出来说我是跨性别这件事情。然后国外可能也是，但是台湾的这个想法会比较重一点，所以导致说很多跨性别朋友反而会比较很低调，不敢展现自己。
What's interesting here and perhaps a little bit troubling, despite Taiwan's openness and perhaps being one of the most progressive places in the region when it comes to LGBTQ plus issues, in this year's general election, all 113 seats of the legislature are being contested. And of the 505 registered candidates, only 7 are openly LGBTQ plus. So I need to ask you, Joyce, what does this say to you about the political and social climate for the LGBTQ plus community?
Actually, previously, you can see like the openly lesbian candidate, Miao Boya, she's now the first lesbian counselor in our country, and there are some other opponent and from the other political party trying to make that she's not girly enough, so people shouldn't vote for her. So this kind of attack still exists in Taiwan's political environment. I think that's also show how difficult for the LGBTI community when they want to step into politics, they want to devote themselves into public interest. It's difficult to reveal themselves as an LGBTI member. So when they reveal, they might face the attack what Miao faced right now. So the things we are thinking, we also heard some very friendly counselor told us that it's their supporter stop them to come out to be themselves because it might affect their election.
What do you think is lacking here in society? Like, why do you think this is affecting politics so much?
I think for candidates and some of their like supporters, they are still worried about if an LGBT candidate like come out publicly, they will like he or she will lose votes. Yeah, so I think we still need to do more to let the whole society to understand about like your professional, your professions. It's not related to your sexual orientation or gender identity. Actually, like straight people, LGBT people, we can all become a very successful and professional like politicians.
What is medical access to both gender reassignment surgery and hormone replacement therapy like here in Taiwan?
Okay, so in Taiwan, although we have a national health insurance systems, all these gender-affirming healthcare aren't included in the insurance. So it kind of depends on which doctor you see. Sometimes you're very lucky, then you will get your hormone paid by the insurance, but usually that's not the case. And because of these surgeries being self-paid, so it's actually quite expensive. So take me as an example, when I had my top surgery, it's like about 160 to 180,000 Taiwanese dollars. And that's actually a lot of money, and a lot of people can't access it because of financial reasons. As we said, like, trans people are often having difficulties in entering job markets, right? And in general, if you want to have hormone in a like normal healthcare system, then you need at least one psychiatrist to give you approve of like gender dysphoria diagnosis, and then you can start to take hormones. Yeah, that's the big picture of the healthcare in Taiwan.
For people who are struggling for their identity, I just want to say that you are not alone.